A major ports dispute could cripple Christmas deliveries and the movement of cruise ships around the country. The nation's largest tugboat operator says it'll lock the gates at 17 ports, shutting out hundreds of employees after a breakdown in wage negotiations.
Tugboats are the lifeblood of the nation's ports, providing a steady guide for container and cruise ships. Now the nation's largest operator, Svitzer, is threatening to cripple the shipping industry.
And basically hold everybody else to ransom because of their, you know, their lack of willingness to resolve the dispute.
Svitzer says it will lock out its almost 600 employees from 17 Australian ports from midday Friday after 3 years of negotiations on a new enterprise agreement broke down.
As you can imagine, it is a very difficult decision to take. We recognise and frankly upfront apologise for the impact it is having to a much wider community of importers and exporters and end consumers in the end.
The company and the union each held talks with the Transport Minister today to try to break the deadlock.
I'm hoping to get harmony.
None was found.
As early as this Friday, we will be seeing the New South Wales economy suffering terribly as a result of this action.
Federal Workplace Minister Tony Burke has urged the company to delay its action, arguing new laws will allow the Fair Work Commission to arbitrate intractable disputes. Now, Svitzer hasn't agreed to that, but will meet the minister in Canberra on Thursday.
It doesn't just affect the people who work there. It affects the people at the ports, it then affects the truck drivers, it affects the people at the warehouses, and ultimately you end up shopping at Christmas time and what you need on the shelves isn't there.
The Maritime Union argues it's negotiated in good faith, accusing the company of arrogance.
Svitzer's just come out with a lot of misinformation. If they were fair digging, they'd be sitting down today to get it fixed.
Svitzer's tugs rescued the Pacific Basin cargo ship when it became stranded off the New South Wales south coast earlier this year, just two of the 100 vessels it operates. The Danish company says it simply wants to make its workforce more adaptable in order to better compete. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.